All right, I wanted to quickly show you how to edit elements in the mobile view in addition to the desktop. So here we are in the Wix editor. This is a slideshow. I have just eliminated it to just one slide. We do have a backup, a duplicate of the homepage here that we can restore once things get back to normal. But for now, we'll just keep this one slide with this COVID notice. So I've kind of prettied it up a little bit, make it look a little bit better and match the site. And what I've done too is in mobile, I have basically moved it down below the slide. So we have the pretty slide of the bridge and then the notice is right below it. So that said, if you make changes to this, if you make changes to just this text in the desktop view, and remember you can only edit it in desktop, you can move it around and do stuff in mobile, but you can't really edit the text itself. But if you edit this text, it will automatically update the mobile view, and it probably won't, you probably don't need to do anything because it'll just add and change this text here. But if you, let's say, add another text box or a new element or something, that's when it might not look good in mobile or not appear in mobile. And here's a couple tricks for that. You'll notice when I click on any item, there is this little hide element option. And so sometimes if you add a new element, it may be hidden on the page before when you come in here. So to get it unhidden, you come over here to hidden elements, and then you can show any of the elements that are hidden. And if you just roll over this little plus, it'll quickly show you kind of what it is that's hidden. In this case, you see that line over there by locations that's going vertical. That's a hidden one. We don't need that piece. We might want a strip. We don't need that strip. But you can kind of go through each of these, and then it scrolls and shows you what it is that is hidden, and then you can decide if you want to unhide it or not. That said, let's go back up here. There's a few other things that you can do. If you want to make this font bigger or smaller, you can use these little plus or negative symbols. You can also click on settings and change them manually here, so you can say 12 point or something like that. So in fact, I think I am going to make it bigger because you know, you probably have a lot of older audiences and they might need to be able to read this a little bit easier. So I'll make it a little bit bigger for that reason. You can move it around like this, you know, just click on things and hold it, and Wix will kind of guide you as to if it's centered in place. You'll see those little pink guidelines that show up. So I use those a lot. You can move things. So in this case, I moved this whole box off of the slide down below it. So, and I just did that by kind of grabbing it and moving it this way. If things are overlapped, let's say this item was behind like this. You want to just click on it, and then you can use the arrows to kind of pull it, or let's see, you can click on it, hold it, and drag it. So that's kind of the way. You can also use a lot of times your keys. So if you click on it once and it's highlighted and you see that little strip, you can use your keypad, the arrows on your keypad, to kind of bump it up and down as desired. Also, you'll see that if you have a big gap, Wix will even prompt you to delete spaces if there's spaces between items. Scrolling down here, let's say here's the footer. Let's say there's a big blank spot on the end of the page or whatever. You'll see when I click on things, I get this little drag handle. What's it called? Use the stretch handle, that's what they call it. And that actually pulls up everything in sync with what's below it. So it's a nice tool to use to kind of shuffle things around. Manage columns. If I click on these, this is kind of a two-column strip, so I could actually change the order of the pictures by clicking on Manage Columns and then kind of using this little column to kind of rotate them. So these are all just a few little tricks to get it where you want it to be. So right here, retinal conditions, that's kind of overlapped. So I'm going to pull this down a little bit, give it a little more space. But yeah, I think everything else is looking good. So those are my quick tips. Make sure you hit publish when you're done to go live to the existing site. And of course, go back and check your desktop version too as well. Make sure everything looks good there. All these same types of tools are available in desktop, such as the stretch handle. Another thing you would ask me about is how you change a button design. So you just want to click here on design, and then you can choose any of these other button designs to change it to. These are the ones that we're using on the site. So In this case, this is the one that's appropriate. So I've already changed these, but if you want to change them again, you're welcome to change them, or if you have to change the text and so forth. If you really want to change the font even more, you can go into Customize and come down to Text and change fonts and so forth. But what's nice is that these preset designs are ones that are already set up to match the existing design of the site, so you're welcome to use any of these. If you need to change the text, you can just click on Change Text and click here. You can also change where it links to. So those are just some little button tips of like, okay, if I want to link to this to a different page, you can choose a page to link to. You can also choose to link to an outside website. You can choose to link to an email or a phone number. So there's lots of options over here on the left-hand side to change where these links go. So I think that covers at least some of your basic questions. Let me know if you have more questions, but hopefully this will get you guys what you need so you can keep editing this going forward. And then let me know. We can always restore this old home page once things go back to normal. This is the one that has more of the slides. I do need to kind of fix it up a little bit, but this has all those old slides that we had before, so we can restore those once we're ready. So, but for now, we'll just keep the one slide, keep this message strong and in the front, and that way hopefully it can notify all your patients of what's going on and how you guys are approaching the situation. Well, happy Wixing, and good luck with everything, and let me know if you have any other questions, of course. Thanks.